With me now on the line is Jay Bhattacherjee, Chief Executive of Aminex. Jay, good morning. Good to speak to you.
Nice to hear from you. Thanks for taking your time today.
Jay, good to speak to you. You've announced this morning you're now debt-free after repaying your loan facility. This is part of your operational update. But first off, the cash side of things, you've described it as a major milestone for you.
Yeah, I mean, obviously, for a company of our size, you know, in an era where you're hearing so many of our peers, you know, coming back with having to go to the, you know, to their debt facility or to their debt holders in specific, asking for extensions or loan repayment help or any of this kind of stuff. For us to be debt free completely, not only is a big milestone, but really establishes a new base for the business to grow from.
Very good, Joe. As far as operations are concerned, let's kick off with Kilawani North. There's been some delay in payment in the past, but it's starting to come through?
There actually hasn't been too much delay in the past. I think the delays are more towards 2017 themselves. And you know, we're sitting at, on average right now, we're owed basically February onwards right now. But we're working with the government. They're making payments as fast as they can. It's not that TPDC doesn't want to make the payments. It's more so that the collection of money from Tanesco has been a bit of an issue. But we're getting the money, you know, more or less on time. And we've been working, as I said, hand-in-hand with TPDC and the government, and we expect to continue to do that.
What kind of production have you been achieving at Kilawani North so far this year?
Yeah, we're still averaging about 15 million cubic feet a day for the first 5 months of 2017. We are maintaining that some days it's more, some days a little less, but on average it's that rate. We're still getting paid about 330 in MCF in that range because our gas is quite lean up there. We're being paid in US dollars, which is a big plus for us as well. It's been a really good project for us, and we're just moving forward with that.
And moving forward, what are the plans? You're looking at re-entering Kilawani North 1 later this year, are you?
Yeah, it's a pretty cheap, pretty simple data gathering exercise. It's going to help us. What we're planning to do is lower a downhole pressure gauge, probably run some production logging tools to not only see the extent of the resource that we have left remaining, but also to just make sure that the perforations that we have in the hole are still good, that they're flowing, that they're not plugged up. It's pretty routine. It's nothing complicated.
And as far as Notoria is concerned, Jay, you're planning the next well. What's the latest there?
Yeah, I mean, Rovuma very much is a big focus for the company, as you can appreciate. It's a pretty special basin, and you know, we're not only planning the next well, but subsequent wells after that as well. So we're working on our basin model right now, and what we're looking to do is evaluate some of the deeper targets there, not only for liquids potential, but there's quite a possibility that there's you know, the Cretaceous systems that we've been drilling into are big, but there's a possibility that some of the deeper Triassic, Jurassic reservoirs are even bigger. So we're working on that model right now. As I said, Antoria 3, you know, is more or less ready to go, but we want to make sure that when we go into Antoria 3, we maximize as many targets as we possibly can.
Very good, Jay. Just look, a quick final word from you. I know you refer to the political uncertainties around Tanzania's mining industry, but you're pretty confident it won't affect domestic gas supplies there?
Yeah, you know, it's in a perverse way good for us in that if the mining sector one day does require the resources to be smelted and refined in country, they're going to need a lot of gas. But in an overall sense of the word, you know, we work on a daily basis with TPDC, which is the government. We haven't seen any effect currently, any spillover effect into the oil and gas sector, and we. You know, we're just going to keep working directly with the government. All of our projects are with the government. They're not independent of the government. And none of our products are for export. They're all for domestic consumption. So there's a bit of a difference between the what's happening in the mining sector and what's happening with us.
Jay, good to speak to you. Nice to hear things are coming along well for you. We'll speak again soon.
Appreciate it. Thanks a lot.